The NATO alliance is fighting two wars tonight in Libya and Afghanistan. The members of the North Atlantic Alliance are supposed to be America's best friends, but you wouldn't know it by the very undiplomatic parting shot taken today by the U.S. Defense Secretary. Here's David Martin.
At the end of his last overseas trip as Secretary of Defense, Gates told his fellow NATO defense ministers what he really thinks of America's oldest military alliance. He accused many of the other 27 members of freeloading.
If you told the American taxpayers, as I just did, that they're bearing 75% of the financial burden of the alliance, this is going to raise eyebrows.
He didn't name names, but look at what members of NATO spend on defense as a percentage of their gross domestic product. Most of them are between 1 and 2% of GDP, while the U.S. is up at 5.4%. The result, said Gates, is what is currently happening with the NATO air campaign in Libya.
The mightiest military alliance in history is only 11 weeks into an operation against a poorly armed regime in a sparsely populated country. Yet many allies are beginning to run short of munitions, requiring the U.S. once more to make up the difference.
Created to protect Western Europe from the now vanished threat of a Soviet invasion, NATO today encompasses countries once on the other side of the Iron Curtain and operates as far away as Afghanistan, where, Gates said, NATO is not carrying its weight. Some countries put restrictions on what kind of operations they will perform and decide for themselves when they will leave.
We cannot afford to have some troop-contributing nations pull out their forces on their own timeline in a way that undermines the mission and increases the risks for other allies.
All of Gates' complaints have been heard before, but coming so bluntly from someone of his stature, it amounts to saying the emperor has no clothes.
What I've sketched out is the real possibility for a dim, if not dismal, future for the transatlantic alliance.
With just 3 weeks left as Secretary of Defense, Robert Gates is at last free to speak his mind.
Thank you, David.